joining us at the table today is media personality Dakari Turner. Thanks so much for being here.
Hey, hey.
Hey, guys. Hey, everybody. How's
and Deanna got you all lubed up for the
little.
Well, it's hand sanitizer, Amy. That would be a whole different show, let me tell you.
Throwing this away.
Table slap.
I can't do anything.
We were just kind of talking off the break, not to harp on it too much, but I don't know. Did you think things have changed, shifted? You worried about anything with the coronavirus, anything? You feeling okay?
I got to say, you know, before last night, when the NBA postponed the games and the game itself was canceled, I thought about it in one way, and that is that, you know, it hadn't really hit here. You know, we saw cases. There was clusters in Seattle, New York, parts of California. But when last night happened, I got to say that changed it for me. It's like, this is a real thing, you know? This is serious.
And I think that's because, you know, the NBA, March Madness, the president spoke.
Everything.
Like, it was just like kind of snowballed
last night. One day.
Like, cascading a little bit.
Yeah. Okay. All right, let's get to it. From Instagram pics to TikTok, many of us are guilty at checking out social media profiles of complete strangers. Experts have said constant screen time can cause decreased social activity and sleeping disorders. New research has found seeing online strangers is no different than seeing strangers in real life. So has social media lurking become the same as people watching on the streets?
I think so. For me, you know, last night I put something out on Twitter. I said the comments are always lit, right? Because I'm always looking at what people are saying, and then I start doing a little stalking.
Yeah, you do deep dives.
Right, a little dive down a rabbit hole.
Right. I think you have to.
Yeah, you can't stop. You can't. And also, I feel like I like people watching. I don't know if that makes me weird or creepy.
No, I love it.
I was just in Mexico doing nothing, just sitting by the pool, and I was like, you know? And then you look at someone do something, and you're like, huh.
For me, going to Vegas, one of my favorite parts is just watching the people up and down the strip, what they're doing, how they're stumbling, what they're up to. But the article that kind of prompted this was fascinating to look at how much our brains can actually kind of consume. They have some numbers around it. They say there's some science that there's about 1,500 people we can recognize, like faces and names, where that's about our capacity of our brains, maybe mine a little bit less. But only about 150 people are we actually able to know a bunch of facts about them, keep up with them, that we actually cannot interact more than that. So the article was fascinating, the idea that by interacting with people more on social media, we're diluting our relationship a little bit because our capacity in our brain isn't big enough to handle all those interactions.
Also, I feel like for those 150 people, the article had also mentioned that you have to be in constant contact with them, right? So you have to make sure that you communicate with them or you talk to them at least once a day or something like that. Obviously, the 1,500 people, who knows who they are? You probably just see them on your social media feed. But I feel like I still don't really keep up with 150 people.
Well, for sure.
I may just not have friends. I don't know.
No, we talked about that last week about our close friends getting down, but the idea being that if you go down a rabbit hole down on someone on Instagram, then you've eliminated one other person that you might actually know from being able to keep up with them in your brain. Just the science behind it was interesting.
How much time do you think you spend just looking for at people?
I think I spend entirely too much time looking at people. I try to cut that down, but I know when I get on social media, that's kind of the first thing I do. Mm-hmm. Looking at what's going on, that's a secondary thing. Looking at all that stuff and trying to keep track of the people, it gets a little bit hectic. I know 150 people for me.
Yeah.
It's probably a little hot.
Yeah, me too, for sure. And I notice sometimes when I get on social media, I go on there for an actual purpose and get sidetracked by other things. And I'm like, wait, what was I supposed to be doing?
Yeah.
I do that all the time.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And the fact that there's a whole nother app now for this sort of thing. Are you a TikToker yet? Are you on board?
I am not a TikToker. I am one of the last holdouts, I think.
No, I'm not a TikToker.
I don't have the app. Okay. No. But I will say my boyfriend has it on his phone, and so I'm like this.
Yeah, you're always looking.
And I'm like, damn.
You're a TikTok lurker. Are you guys ready to have a little fun?
Yes.
All right. Well, we're already having fun. We'll have more fun. This is called Slap That Desk, or Slap the Desk, whatever you want to say. This is Smarter Than a 10-Year-Old Edition.
Okay.
So we found a fun little elementary school quiz, or things that you learn in elementary school, and if you think you know the answer, slap the desk and yell it on out.
I have an almost 10-year-old in the house.
So we're judging you.
With math, I'll forget it.
I think you guys will be okay. All right?
Yeah.
How many continents are there?
Seven.
Yes, there are seven.
Can't remember.
Really?
Yeah, I always forget.
Seven.
Right. You guys blanked on that?
I totally blanked.
Oh, man.
Okay. Oh, I'm ready. Oh, my God.
I would love to say I'm not judging, but I hardcore am. How many states are there in the U.S.?
50.
Well, Deanna, see, I have to call on you after you slap that desk. Amy had it first.
Okay.
50.
Yeah, exactly. 1-1.
I got to pick this up.
Right. What is closer to the Earth, the moon or the sun?
I was giving you
I was gonna let you have it.
Me?
Here, we're gonna let him answer.
Answer.
The moon or the sun, it is It's the moon.
Yeah!
All right.
All right. Yes.
Oh my gosh, people.
All right. It's tied, right? We all got one. Okay.
All right. Yeah, the sun's about like 300 times further away. All right. Which of these countries is not in Europe? This is multiple choice.
There we go.
Is it Albania, Spain, Sweden, or Yemen? Jakari.
Is it Spain?
Nope. That is definitely in Europe. Deanna?
Yemen,
yes, that's on the Arabian Peninsula there.
Oh, okay.
All right. This one I had no clue about, so don't feel bad.
Well,
what? Not that you should anyways, yeah. What is the capital of Australia? Is it Melbourne?
Perth.
No. Canberra, Sydney, or Wellington?
Sydney.
No.
Melbourne?
Nope, it is Canberra, which I never even heard of, and that's the capital of Australia.
I just want to say shout out to the DJ for shouting out the wrong answers.
Oh, so you're blaming DJ Mustafa Rocks for your answers.
Slapping the turntable.
All right, what is the biggest ocean? Do you need the multiple choice? Yeah.
Ooh. Atlantic?
No.
It's the Pacific?
Yes, it's the Pacific.
You got the answers before.
Yeah, you're looking at
No,
I
didn't put the answers on here. Just because I knew Deanna would cheat if I did.
What?
No, I'm just kidding.
You didn't even know I was hosting today.
That's true. Let's take a look at what is the largest planet in the solar system?
The largest planet?
Yes.
I'm gonna go out there.
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna go out there. Is it Saturn?
No, but it is really
Mercury.
Big. No, that's one of the smallest. It's Jupiter. You can fit 1,000 Earths in Jupiter. All right, that's it.
Sometimes
we lose.
You know?
Slap that desk.
Wait,
we all deserve a slap.
I answered
that's
many
it,
no. Dakari,
thank you so much for being here. We'll make sure we get all the social media up there on the screen so you can follow him as well. There we go. Dakari Turner on Instagram and Twitter as well. Thanks so much for being here.
Are you sitting on an escalator there? Was it moving?
That's my album cover.
Oh, I like it. I like it.